A very warm welcome to all from Aashahs Young IAS. In this presentation, we are going to understand what are the courses which we have developed here at Aashahs Young IAS and their purpose. So we cater to students from as early as standard second, going till graduation, till competitive exams which are conducted by government like UPSC Civil Services exam. So for young students, what we see is that at a later stage, they find it difficult to select proper stream and subject for them. What is the reason for this? The reason for this is that students and parents are unable to identify the interest and potential of the child. The strongest indicator of talent in young students is to track their interest, curiosity, and fascination. So it is very important to identify and develop the talent of the student, and the earlier it is done, the better, the easier the life is for the student. If he knows at an early stage what he aspires to be. So that's what we are aiming towards. So this course as such, the courses which we have developed here, they give an opportunity for this child to develop to his or her full potential. It empowers young students. We reach out to them, responding to their expectations and ideas, and foster useful and long-lasting skills. So the course which we have formulated, the first one, Young IAS Talent Hunt. This is a course to train students to use their brain to its fullest capacity. So they will shine not just academically, but as well as in competitive exams and future career. So this is a course which will nurture the talent of the students at an early stage. It will be for their concept clearance, analytical ability, as well as having an external outlook. So there are many competitive exams, many scholarship exams which are conducted for school students, many government-based exams, as well as exams which are conducted later for jobs, job opportunities in private sector as well as in public sector. These competitive exams have these analytical ability at their base. So developing it at this early stage, and each course is catering to that standard. So standard-wise courses are developed. So that is what will be offered to the students to nurture them academically as well as to enhance their personality and overall outlook. So Young IAS Talent Hunt will be the base and starting point for each student to get ready for other government scholarship exams and reputed exams which are conducted. So this course as such, you can see, we'll be providing training in four aspects. One is intelligence test. Second, quantitative aptitude, which is mathematics, mental maths. Third is English language. And fourth is general knowledge. So what analytical ability we speak of is the intelligence test. Mathematical ability is quantitative aptitude. And the language is important, English language and GK, general knowledge and current affairs. So these aspects would be covered in the course throughout the academic year standard wise. So there are separate courses formulated for each standard, from standard 2 till standard 10. So there'll be regular tests and assignments along with the course. And at the end of the course, Young IAS Talent Hunt Scholarship Exam will be conducted standard-wise, wherein successful students will be awarded certificate and a scholarship amount. So the pattern of the examination, which will be in MCQ format, multiple choice question format, which will be conducted offline in the classroom. The exam pattern, there'll be two papers, paper 1 and paper 2. Each paper would have two sections, section A and section B. So paper 1, section A would have English language, where there will be 25 questions. Section B will have quantitative aptitude, mental maths, which will comprise of 50 questions. Paper 2, section A would have current affairs and GK, which would comprise of 25 questions. And paper 2, section B would be intelligence test, comprising of 50 questions. So there'll be total, you can see, 75 questions in paper 1 and 75 questions in paper 2. Each question is worth 2 marks and there'll be no negative marking. So each paper is for 150 marks. So total marks will be 300 marks. The duration for each paper is also 1 hour 30 minutes. That is around 90 minutes for paper 1 and 90 minutes for paper 2. Qualifying criteria is the minimum qualifying marks which you'll require will be 50% in each section of both the papers. So 50% in English language, 50% in quantitative aptitude, 50% in current affairs and GK, as well as 50% in intelligence test in each of the sections. So that is about this course. Then we also have other courses which are conducted, like one is on essay writing. So we'll have such contests which are conducted. So essay will be on a given topic written by the students. So that which will help the teachers and examiners to understand the thinking process of the student. So writing essay in a given period of time develops time management skills. It displays level of command over the language as well as the topic. As such, essay writing contest will provide a platform to the students to showcase their talent, on the basis of which teachers can further work upon the students on developing the skill of writing good essays. Then we also have handwriting contests. So good handwriting skill leads to stronger academic performance too. It boosts memory. As such, when you do handwriting practice, it has positive impact on the students as such too, and the presentation of an answer of the student too. Illegible handwriting can cause poor self-esteem too. Poor self-esteem can trigger loss of confidence in the students. So good handwriting is a key to progress and success. So participation in handwriting contests will bring healthy competition and will motivate students to improve. Then we also have courses for public speaking. So these will be contests which will be held for public speaking and story reading. So good leaders need communication skills to be effective, and people with good communication skills are more likely to be promoted to leadership positions in their career as such too. So the most powerful tool in today's world is the ability to communicate effectively. So it could be presentation, a speech, an interview, or even negotiating a deal. Smart communicators often outsmart talented and deserving professionals who are poor in their communication skills. So for students of primary section, the contest will be of story reading or storytelling, whereas for secondary section, the contest will be for elocution, public speaking. And this contest will be organized to identify and nurture the students having potential to become good public speakers. So interested students may enroll for this course too. Later on, wherein this skill will be ingrained in the students extensively and exhaustively by a series of exercises, presentations, and role plays, by using scientific methods like psychology, psychotherapy, using CBT and REBT techniques. So this will help students in developing public speaking skills too. So we'll be working on the students on this aspect as well. Then we also have Kaun Banega IAS, which is a quiz show which is conducted. So we have this quiz show conducted, and it is aired on our YouTube channel, aashahyoungias. So it is a fun part to the entire series of programs which we provide, and it is learning, and it also arouses competitive spirit amongst the students.
नमस्ते लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, मैं रुखसार आप सभी का फिर एक बार स्वागत करती हूँ कौन बनेगा आईएएस में। और आज का हमारा एपिसोड है किड्स स्पेशल। तो इट्स किड्स स्पेशल एपिसोड में जो आज के हमारे कंटेस्टेंट है वो है मास्टर रुवाद। प्लीज वेलकम मास्टर रुवाद। हेलो रुवाद, हाउ आर यू?
फाइन।
कैसा लग रहा है आपको कौन बनेगा आईएएस में आके?
अच्छा लग रहा है।
अच्छा लग रहा है, तो आप रेडी है खेलने के लिए कौन बनेगा आईएएस? ऑलराइट रुवाद, प्लीज हैव अ सीट।
ओके रुवाद, तो स्टार्ट करते हैं फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन से। फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन आपकी स्क्रीन पर ये रहा, व्हाट इज द कैपिटल ऑफ तेलंगाना? एंड योर ऑप्शंस आर ए अमरावती, बी बेंगलुरु, सी हैदराबाद, एंड डी चेन्नई।
हैदराबाद।
सी हैदराबाद, आर यू श्योर?
यस।
ओके कंप्यूटर, सी हैदराबाद में लॉक लगाया, हमें बताइए सही उत्तर है या नहीं। यस,
क्योंकि पहले नहीं हैदराबाद का कैपिटल, नहीं आंध्र प्रदेश का कैपिटल हैदराबाद था, फिर तेलंगाना के लोग बोल रहे थे कि ये तेलंगाना बनाओ, ये तेलंगाना बनाओ, फिर बन गया। हाँ, फिर चेंज कर दिया आंध्र प्रदेश का कैपिटल और तेलंगाना हैदराबाद बन गया।
तो अभी आंध्र प्रदेश का कैपिटल क्या है?
So here are some links to the course, to the videos of our young IAS, Kaun Banega IAS. Then also we have sports, which we emphasize on. So it is rightly said that healthy mind with healthy body makes healthy life. So emphasis on sports is also important. In today's world, students find very little time for sports or for taking care of their body and health. And there are great benefits of playing sport. To name a few, better sleep, reduced stress, increased confidence, improved mental health as well as physical health, and development of a sense of friendliness and sportsmanship. So in order to have overall development of personality of students, Aashahs Young IAS has also included sports in its programs. So various sports like volleyball, basketball, badminton, boxing, karate will be provided to students of Young IAS Talent Hunt. So benefits of Young IAS Talent Hunt. One, it provides updated information about various scholarship exams. Second, it prepares for various scholarship exams with extensive practice. Third, it provides strong foundation for scholarship and competitive exams. Fourth, it improves academic performance. Fifth, it helps the student in getting social recognition and monetary benefits. Sixth, it helps in identifying the strong and weak points of the students. Seventh, it reveals the interest and aptitude of the student. Eighth, it assists in shortlisting the career options at the later stage. And finally, it enhances knowledge and personality of the student for school level and inter-school level competitive exams. So the highlights of our Young IAS Talent Hunt course at Aashahs is, we make learning easy with fun. Emphasis is on concept clearance of the subject. Standard-wise difficulty level is taken care of. Each course is prepared standard-wise. There is suitable structure and schedule prepared to match with the academic timetable of the student. And there will be combination of classroom as well as online learning. And a certificate would be provided to students on successful completion of the course. Prizes and trophies would be awarded to winners of various contests which will be conducted at Aashahs Young IAS at regular intervals. So we have a lot to offer, and students, believe me, have a lot to take in. We require cooperation and a strong, long-lasting bond with students as well as teachers to sail through academically as well as in competitive world. Wishing you all the very best. Thank you.